Hello internet people, this is Yasir from WP Haono, and in this video we are going to cover a brief introduction to Infinity Free web hosting and features of its Infinity Free plan. Then we will create an account on Infinity Free web hosting. Then we will set up a hosting account for our website within Infinity Free account that we have created, and after that we will install WordPress in it for free. And we will also see how to access WordPress website files and its associated database. So without wasting any time, let's get started. But before that, if you want to get more tutorials about WordPress and web hosting, then please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can get notified every time we publish the new content for our viewers. So basically, Infinity Free web hosting is sponsored by a company called iFastnet, which handles the premium hosting plans, while the free plan is managed by Infinity Free web hosting itself. Let's see some of the features that Infinity Free web hosting provides in its Infinity Free plan. First of all, it provides Vista panel that helps you in the management of the web server. And the company seems to provide unlimited resources like unlimited disk space, unlimited databases, and unlimited bandwidth. But here the term unlimited has some restrictions, and Infinity Free keeps the right to suspend your account anytime if there is an excess amount of resources used. In Infinity Free plan, you would only get just one FTP account, and the number of files you can have on the server are up to 30,019. One other feature that Infinity Free provides in Vista panel is Softaculous Apps Installer, which can be used to easily install different services like WordPress, PrestaShop, Joomla, and many others in a few clicks. Now let's see how to create an account on Infinity Free web hosting. For that, first of all, let's go to infinityfree.net, and from here click on button saying sign up now. On the sign up button, first enter your email address, then set a password for your account, then confirm your password, accept the term of services, and in the end verify that you are not a robot by clicking here, and then click on create new account button. Now it is saying that an activation email has been sent to your email address. So let's check the email to verify our account. Open the verification email and click on verify email address link. And with this, our Infinity Free account has been created successfully. Now within the Infinity Free account, we have to set up the hosting account from where we will manage our website. Infinity Free allows you to create three web hosting accounts, which means you can create three different websites using one Infinity Free account. To create a hosting account, click on Create Account button here. First step here is to choose a domain name. If you have a custom domain name, you can use it by pointing the domain to the Infinity Free name servers. But for simplicity, we will select the subdomain option. Here, enter the name that you want to use for your website, let's say WP Haono, and from here select the domain extension that will come after your domain name. So now our website address will be wphaono.rf.gd. After that, click on search domain button. If the domain is available, you will be redirected to a second step where it will ask for the additional information. Here, set a label for your hosting account so that when you are in the Infinity Free account, you can easily distinguish which hosting account is associated with which website. Account username will be generated automatically, so leave it as it is. And if you want, you can set a password for the hosting account yourself, or leave this field blank if you want it to be generated automatically. We will leave this field blank so the password will be generated automatically. Both the randomly generated username and password will be available in the client area that we will see in the next step. After this, verify that you are not a robot and click on Create Account button. And with this, our hosting account has been created successfully, and you can see the notification that is indicated that our account has been created. Here it is giving us two options: view in client area and open control panel. As we can access control panel from within the client area, so we will go with this option, view in client area. Here you can see the notification that is saying that it can take up to 72 hours for some domains to start working. So if your domain does not work right after the creation, you would have to wait for some time for it to be functional. Here you can see the account details of your hosting account, like the username label for the hosting account that can be changed anytime by going into the edit section. The main domain, you don't have to worry about this. It is an internal identifier for Infinity Free. IP address of your hosting, hosting volume, status of the hosting. Active means that you are good to go with the website creation, and finally the password of your current hosting account. Similarly, you can see the FTP details and MySQL details of your hosting from within the client area. Now let's go to the Vista panel provided by Infinity Free by clicking the control panel button here. Here it is asking for the permissions to send emails to your email address that you have provided. If you choose to click on I disapprove, you may lose your account. So in order to avoid that, click on I approve button. And after that, it will redirect you to the Vista panel. Now we are in the control panel of our hosting account, from where we can manage different things related to the server, like databases, domains and emails, etc. And on the right side, you can see the stats of your account, like what plan are you using, how many FTP accounts you currently have, MySQL databases, how much disk space you used, inode used, bandwidth used or daily hits used. Now let's see how to install WordPress on the hosting account. For that, we will use Softaculous Apps Installer, and it will help us to install and set up WordPress in minutes. So under software section, click on Softaculous Apps Installer and it will redirect you to another page. Here it will give you the option to install different services like PrestaShop, Joomla and PSP, BB, etc. But as we want to install WordPress, so we will click on install button that is on WordPress. Now it will ask for basic information for setting up WordPress, like which version of WordPress would we like to install. We will go with the latest version. For protocol, we will just use HTTP, as Infinity Free does not provide SSL certificate in its Infinity Free plan. As we have just created one domain, so we will select it from here. Leave this directory blank so that WordPress website files install in the main directory. Now here it is asking for the site name, which will be your WordPress website's title. In our case, it will be WP How Now. And here it is asking for the site description. We will leave it as it is. Both site name and site description can be changed later from WordPress admin dashboard. We don't want multi-site features, so we will leave it unchecked. And here it is asking for the admin username and admin password that will be used to log in into your WordPress dashboard. So remember these credentials, as you will need these to log in into your WordPress admin panel. For security, keep the strength of password strong so that it is not easy to guess your password. Here, write in the email address that you want to set. Choose the default language for your WordPress website here. And in this section, it is giving us option to install some plugins. The plugin Limit Login Attempts is a security plugin, and it is recommended because it will help you to limit the number of login attempts on your website. And if you don't like the WordPress new default Gutenberg editor, you can install Classic Editor plugin to deactivate the Gutenberg editor and use the old Classic Editor. As for now, we want both plugins, so we will check the boxes in front of them. Now if you click on Advanced Option tab, here it will give you the option to set your database name and tables prefix. Let's say we want our database name to be wp-hano and we want every table's prefix to be wp-hk. And here it is giving us option to auto upgrade our WordPress, its plugins and themes. But for now, we don't want to upgrade these things automatically, so we will leave these options unchecked. Also, leave the backup location as default. After setting the advanced options, it is asking us to select the theme that we will like to install on our WordPress website. But this option is not mandatory as WordPress already comes with some of its own themes, so we will not select any theme from here. Now we are good to go for the installation of WordPress, so click on install button. Now it will take a while to install the WordPress. Meanwhile, please take a moment to like this video and consider subscribing to our YouTube channel for more WordPress and web hosting related tutorials. Now WordPress has been installed on our website. To check, let's go to the website. Here is the URL of our website, so we will click on it. And here you can see that WordPress has been installed successfully and the website is up and running. And the theme it is using by default is 2020 theme. Now to log in into WordPress admin area, write wp-admin in front of the website name in the URL and hit enter. This is the WordPress website's admin login page. Write in the username and password that you had set while installing the WordPress. And after that, click on login button. After successful login, now you are in the WordPress dashboard area. Here you can explore all about your WordPress website. For example, to see which themes are installed on the website and which is currently active on your website, go to theme section under appearance. Here you can see all the themes that are installed on your website and which theme is currently active. And if you want to delete the unused themes, you can do that easily. To do that, select the theme that you want to uninstall and click on the delete button in the right bottom corner. It will ask for the confirmation, so click on OK here. Now the theme and all of its files has been deleted successfully from the website. You can also install new themes by clicking on add new button here. Same is the case with plugins. In the plugins section, you can see all the plugins that are installed on your WordPress and you can easily activate, deactivate or delete any plugin of your choice from within the WordPress dashboard. And you can also install new plugins by clicking the add new button here. Now let's see actually where all of your WordPress files are installed. For that, once again go to cPanel and find the file section and under it click on online file manager. And from here open stdocs folder. And this is the folder where all of your WordPress website files are installed. And here all the files and folders will be the same for any WordPress website except for the wp-content folder, as this is the folder that will have all of your themes, plugins and media files. So let's open it. This folder themes will contain all of your themes and their files, and the plugins and their files will be present in the plugins folder. And all the images and other files that you will upload from your WordPress will be present in the uploads folder. This was a short introduction to the files and folders of the WordPress. And the actual content of your website like posts, pages and settings of themes and plugins will be saved in different tables in the database. So now let's see which database is connected with your WordPress website. Once again, go to cPanel and find databases section and under databases section, click on phpMyAdmin. This is the database that is connected with your WordPress website. Click on connect now button. And here you can see different tables that are associated with your WordPress website and store different information based on their functionality. Like this table wphk_post. Store data related to your post and pages, and this table wphk_users contains the information about the users of your WordPress website. So that's all for this video, in which we have learned how to install WordPress website on Infinity Free Web Hosting for free and how to access its files and database. In case of any issues while installing the WordPress, do let us know in the comment section below and we will address your issues. We hope you find this video useful. If you do, please hit the like button and share this video. And if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel yet, please do it by clicking the subscribe button below, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can get notified every time we publish new content. Thanks for watching.